Hello friends, in today's lecture we are going to discuss about our next topic, that is magnetic field intensity. Magnetic field intensity. So it is also called as magnetic field strength. Intensity means strength, and this magnetic field intensity is denoted by capital letter H. So how can we define the magnetic field intensity or magnetic field strength? So it is defined as the ratio of magnetic field in vacuum. So it is denoted by V0 to the absolute permeability. And it is denoted by μ0. So this is the definition. So it is defined as the ratio of magnetic field in vacuum to the absolute permeability, and this absolute permeability is denoted by μ0. So I can write here magnetic field in vacuum, it is denoted by B0, it is the ratio to absolute permittivity, absolute permeability, that is μ0. In shortcut we can write here B0 upon μ0, and H, and this formula is generated here. So H is equal to B0 upon μ0. So H is the ratio of B0 to μ0. Means what is H? H is the magnetic field strength or magnetic field intensity. H is a magnetic field intensity or magnetic field strength. So according to the formula, or by seeing the formula, you can easily create its definition. So magnetic field strength is defined as the ratio of magnetic field in vacuum to the absolute permeability μ0. So μ0, the value of μ0 is equal to 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7, and its unit is Tesla, or meter ampere inverse. So unit of magnetic field intensity, unit of magnetic field intensity, this μ0 is a absolute permeability, and its value is 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 Tesla or meter ampere inverse. And unit of magnetic field intensity, means the unit of H, is ampere per meter or Newton per meter square Tesla. Or one more unit is there, that is Newton per Weber. So this is all about the magnetic field intensity. So next point is magnetic line of forces. Magnetic lines of forces. Magnetic line of forces. So we know that, suppose that this is a bar magnet. This is South Pole and this is North Pole. So an imaginary line of force is there. It is not visible thing. It is invisible thing. Or we can't see the line of forces, but can experience by using some by using the other magnet or iron pieces. So let's see. North pole is always get attracted toward the south pole. So line of forces always starts from north pole and ends at south pole. Like this. North pole to south pole. They start from north pole and ends at south pole. So this is called as the magnetic line of forces. So they are similar to the electric line of forces. So only notations will be changed. Here will be positive, here will be a negative. So in case of the magnetic field, south pole is there and here north pole is there. So what is the characteristic of the magnetic line of forces? Actually, what happened at this location, we can see the density of line of forces is very high as compared to this cross section. Here is also one cross section area, here is also one cross section area, but in this cross section area the density is rare. Here the density of line of forces is rare and here density of line of forces is greater or maximum. So actually what happened, when this magnet is dipped in iron filings, so what will happen, the iron filings will get attract towards the both the end of the magnet, north pole and south pole. Why this happened? This happened only because of the strength of magnetic field is greater at the pole as compared to the its middle portion. Very few iron pieces will be attract at the middle place. Why this happened? Because this happened only because of the magnetic line of forces. So here is the cross section area is greater and the density of the line of forces is less. Here cross section area is small, but density of the line of forces is greater. So it is directly proportional to the density of the magnetic field intensity is directly proportional to the density of the magnetic line of forces passing through the cross sectional area. So let's see its characteristics. What is the characteristic of line of forces? Characteristic of magnetic line of forces. Characteristic of magnetic lines of force. First, magnetic line of force always originate from north pole and terminate at the south pole. मैग्नेटिक लाइंस ऑफ कोर्स स्टार्ट्स एट नॉर्थ पोल एंड एंड्स एट साउथ पोल. सेकंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक. सो एज वी सीन इन दिस डायग्राम इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम नॉर्थ पोल एंड एंड्स एट साउथ पोल. इट स्टार्ट्स एट नॉर्थ पोल एंड्स एट साउथ पोल. सो मैग्नेटिक लाइन ऑफ फोर्स स्टार्ट एट नॉर्थ पोल एंड एंड्स एट साउथ पोल. सेकंड, द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड B at any point is long the tangent to the line of forces at that point. The direction of magnetic field at any point, the direction of magnetic field B at any point is along the tangent. To the lines of forces at that point. So let's understand this concept. So this is the line of forces. So if we draw a normal, so we can see that here this is the B, and this B is nothing but the direction of magnetic field, and it is always tangent, means it's touching at any point along the tangent to the line of force at that point. So it always remain tangent. So next characteristic is the magnetic field is represented by the number of field lines per unit cross sectional area at a point under consideration. It means that suppose that this is a magnet, North Pole, South Pole. So the magnitude of the magnetic field is represented by the number of field lines per unit cross section area. So what is this area of cross section and what is this area of cross section? So the strength of magnetic field is depend upon the cross section and number of line passing through that cross section. Fourth point, the magnetic field line of force are denser near the north and south pole. So here the density of the line of forces is greater as compared to the middle part. The magnitude or magnetic the magnetic lines of force, magnetic line of force are denser near the north and south pole, north and south poles, indicating large value of magnetic field, and it indicating large value of magnetic force. Or magnetic field. So the magnetic line of force are rarer at far off points compared to the poles. So fifth point is, so as we go far away from the poles, we find there the line of force, the magnetic line of force are rarer, the magnetic lines of force are rarer at far off points compared to poles, compared two poles. And sixth point is, the line of force never intersect to each other, they are always parallel to each other, and remember that parallel lines do not intersect to each other. So sixth point is, the lines of force never intersect each other. And last point is, all the lines of force have same strength or equal strength. All the line of force, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever line of forces will be there, they have the same strength. So this is all about the today's lecture. In next lecture we will discuss about magnetic field line of the earth. Thank you.